You must think I'm somebody else, or something.
My dear Lady Chivis Cobb, how could I...
I'm not. I'm not, Barbara cried. I'm not her at all. I thought there was something queer about it. The colour faded from Mr. Tyler's rubicund countenance. He staggered to a chair.
What? He said. What? You are not Lady Chivis Cobb?
No, I'm not. I've never even heard of her, Barbara assured him.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear me. This is dreadful. This is really dreadful.
I'm Mrs. Abbott, continued Barbara. Mrs. Arthur Abbott, and I came here to look at the Archway House. Mr. Tyler took out a handkerchief and mopped his face.
This is terrible, he said. This is truly terrible. I shall never get over this. Never.
I'm very sorry, Barbara told him. Her heart was touched at the sight of so much suffering. I really am awfully sorry, but I'd no idea. I mean, I thought you knew who I was. You seemed to be expecting me.
I was expecting her,
said Mr. Tyler faintly. Oh, I see, said Barbara, nodding.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear me,
lamented Mr. Tyler.
And her ladyship was so insistent on discretion. I shall never get over it.
Well, you'll be very silly then, said Barbara firmly. There's no harm done, so far as I can see, except that I've wasted an awful lot of time reading that silly document of yours.
You had no business to read it,
said Mr. Tyler, pulling himself together a little.
Surely you must have seen that it did not concern you.
I didn't want to read it, retorted Barbara indignantly. You told me it was necessary. You said I was to read it. You said you'd explain everything when you came back.